Welcome back to your math video lessons and a continuation of our study of two-step equations. So, we've had a little bit of practice with these things, and because understanding equations is just so ridiculously important in eighth grade, in order for you to have success at the high school, this is a concept that we're going to be working with yet again today, and probably even one more day beyond this. So, let's do some more work with two-step equations. Let's remember what two-step equations are. Those are equations with two different math operations that are going to need to be done in order to get the variable isolated, to get that variable to be alone and happy. So that's why we call them two-steppers, because they're going to have to do two math operations. A couple reminders that you've probably seen a few times now. A reminder that variables want to be alone, and in order to get a variable to be alone with no numbers by him, you always have to do the opposite, and you have to do it to both sides of the equation, meaning to the left side of the equal sign and to the right side of the equal sign. So, in my opinion, the best way to tackle these two-step equations would be down here in blue. Step one is to move the number that is not directly attached to the variable first. So, if I were to show you an example of what I mean, it would be like this. Okay, in this case, step one, the number that is not directly attached to the variable would be this plus 4. I would call that guy the number that's not directly attached. Step two says move the number that is attached to the variable. So then, let's try this. Using the same example, the number that is directly attached to the variable would, in my eyes, the way I see it, is the 3. So we're gonna move the number that's not attached first, and then the number that is directly attached by multiplication or division, that's the number we're gonna move away second or last. Okay, so we have just a few examples, but they're a little bit more challenging than the last examples that we worked with. So looky there, right off the bat. You guys love these, huh? Right? Fractions that are attached to variables. Oh, fun times. Hope you have your calculator handy. Okay. So I'm looking at the -1/6 x, right? That means multiply. That means -1/6 times x. Then I see a -3. It equals 2. Okay. So the x is super grumpy. And he says, I don't want to be multiplied by -1/6, and I don't want there to be a -3 by me. Get it gone, right? Move it. Okay, you know what to do. Always do the opposite. So the number that's not directly attached is the -3, and we're going to undo that first. The opposite of -3, or subtract 3, is add 3. Here, let's draw that line. Sometimes that helps us see the left side and the right side. And if I add 3 to the left, I have to add 3 to the right. I like to cross off those 3s. They create a 0, and we don't need them there anymore. Now I like to rewrite, what do I have on the left side? What do I have on the right side? So on the left side, I still have the -1/6 being multiplied by the x. Then I have my equal sign, and 2 plus 3 is 5. Okay, that was step 1. Step 1 was move the 3. Step 2 is to get rid of that -1/6 that's being multiplied by the x, right? The -1/6 is right next to the x, and when they're right next to each other, that's multiplying. So the opposite of multiply is divide. Divide by the number that's attached to the x, which is the -1/6. Divide by -1/6. Divide by -1/6. Hope you have your calculators handy. Yes, and some of us would struggle doing that division. All of those -1/6 cancel out. X is finally alone, and he's happy, and he's positive, right? He's not a negative x. And you have to solve 5 divided by -1/6. And if you punched in a calculator right, you get a -30. I'm not going to get into the whole dividing by fractions thing, because I feel like You know, that's sixth grade math, that's seventh grade math. You either know how to divide by a fraction or you don't at this point. And if you don't, it's just, you got to work it in a calculator. Because if you know what to do, you would really know that you should flip the 1/6 over so that it's 6/1. And then you would, instead of divide, you would multiply. But again, that's all been covered, and our curriculum, it kind of expects you to know how to tackle those situations. Okay, we're on the problem now on the right-hand side. It says negative 7 equals P divided by negative 5 minus 1. Oh boy, Mr. P over there, super grumpy. Who is not directly attached? I say it's the minus 1. So instead of minus 1 or subtract 1, we do the opposite, and we're going to add 1 to the right side and to the left side of that equal sign. Remember, the equal sign is always the middle. Okay, bye-bye to the 1s. They go away. They create a 0. And P divided by negative 5, that's what I have on the right side. And on the left side, negative 7 and a positive 1, if you combine those, gives you a negative 6. Okay, that was step one. Here's step two. Step two says P does not want to be divided by negative 5. So you're going to do the opposite and multiply. By a negative 5 here, and by a negative 5 there. And I do this, and I say goodbye to the 5s, and I put my equal sign. And P is alone, and he's happy, and he's feeling positive, and he likes all that. And in your calculator, or in your head, negative times negative makes positive, and 6 times 5 is 30. So P is 30. Do you think we're done? Oh, of course not. I've got so many examples. We could do this till Christmas. We won't, but we could. Here's another one. Ready? Negative 16 equals K divided by 2 minus 7. K says, help! I'm irritated. You say, here I come to the rescue. I will rescue K. Come on, you know that's kind of funny. All right, ready? Here we go. K does not like being divided by 2. He does not like being subtracted by 7. So instead of subtract 7, add it. Add it. Cross those guys off. On the right, I still have K divided by 2. On the left, negative 16 plus 7 brings me up to a negative 9. There was step 1. Let's show step 2. Still focusing on the K. He doesn't want to be divided by 2. You're going to come and save the day. I saved the day! I'm going to multiply by 2. Yay! K says, oh, math student, you're my hero. And negative 9 times 2 is negative 18, right? A negative times a positive makes a negative. Good job! A star for you. You did a nice job. Want to do some more? Well, it's your lucky day, because I have 4 more that we're going to do. Okay, let's go. Look at J. Negative 8J minus 7 equals 57. Ready? Who goes first? The 7. And the opposite is add 7. Do-do-do, da-da-da. There's that. There's this. And 57 plus 7 is that. That's step 1. Step 2, J says, get that negative 8 away from me. I don't want to be multiplied by a negative 8. You say, fine. Settle down. I won't multiply you by a negative 8. I'll come along and I'll divide by a negative 8. But I have to remember, Ms. Klessner told me I have to do it on both sides. Da-da! Bye-bye, 8s. J says, you're my hero. And 64 divided by negative 8 is negative 8. Awesome. Let's keep going. I bet you're getting better at these, right? I hope so. All right, let's look at the W. It says 6 minus 3 times W equals negative 27. I'm going to put this over here just so that we're all aware that 6 is really a plus 6, okay? Okay. How do you get rid of a plus 6? You subtract them. Bye-bye, sixes. Bring down. It's not a 3W. It is a negative 3W. And negative 27 minus 6 is negative 33. That's step one. Step two. Instead of multiplying by a negative 3, divide by the negative 3. Are you following this? Negative 33 divided by negative 3, positive 11. We're getting there, and you're getting smarter, so it's all good. Ooh! These next two really are interesting. Okay, looking at the M. Negative 4 equals M divided by negative 8, and then minus 19. I bet you know who goes away first from the M. It's the minus 19. You do the opposite. You add 19, just like so. I do this. Bye-bye to my 19s. I bring down my equal sign. I still have M over negative 8. And on the left side, negative 4 and plus 19 gives me positive 15. Step one. Here's step two. M says, I'm happier, but I'm not happiest, right? I don't want to be divided by negative 8. You say, no problem. I can multiply you by negative 8, and I can make that go away. Always doing the opposite. Dividing and multiplying cancel. M is alone, and he's positive, and he's happy. And calculators, a 15 times negative 8. Negative 120. Put a circle around that. Nah, it's not really a circle, more of an oval. Well, whatever. Let's do just one more. Now, I'm looking at this. I'm going to read it. I'm going to see if you know what to do. So it says 21 minus h equals negative 32. I hope you know to do this. Please. Please, please know to do that. That's just going to make things so much better. Okay, no. H is grumpy. He doesn't like the being multiplied by negative 1. He does not like the positive 21 sitting out there. Let's move the positive 21 or the plus 21 first. Do that. Do that. Do that. Bye-bye. Looky there. Do that. Guess what? Negative 32 minus 21 takes you clear down to negative 53. Better not get that cold this winter or I'm going to snap. All right? Okay, there's step one. Last thing. H is not alone, and he's not positive, and he's still not happy. He's got that negative 1, and he's being multiplied by a negative 1. No go. He doesn't want to be multiplied by a negative 1, so you're going to divide by the negative 1. Oh, he feels so much better. He says, thanks for taking that negative 1 off my shoulders. I don't want him there. So calculators, a negative 53 divided by negative 1, negative divided by negative makes positive, and 53 is your final answer. Holy smokes, that was a lot of examples in day two of working with two-step equations. This is what we'll be doing in class. We're working out of the back of the book. It's 10 questions. Of course, you're going to be asked to show your work. And the nice thing is that there will be no decimal answers. If you get a decimal answer as you're working through these problems, then you have made an error in your computation. I can't wait to see you in class, and we'll work on these together. Don't worry, you will get it.